Okay, I get a lot of people asking me how the first person view video goggle assisted flight works. From my perspective, so I'm going to talk you through this practice flight yesterday up at up in the Wasatch Mountains here. I'm at about 9,500 feet elevation. I took off from a big granite rock right there, which is a nice, easily identifiable spot. If I lose my bearings or something, I whip around and spot that rock, and that's me sitting down there on the rock with the radio. So there you see Silver Lake in the background there. I like coming up and flying in the mountains here because mountains are the most challenging areas. A lot of times I don't see the horizon, so judging whether I'm level or straight or whatever is difficult. Then you got trees, and this has varying elevation where there's slopes and dips and valleys and everything. So it's definitely the best place to practice, and it's just nice being up in the mountains. Today was a little bit windy too, which is great for practicing because it just happens. Here I'm practicing coming in, descending onto myself actually at a nice smooth rate, and there's some vibration coming in. It's descending at a smooth fixed point is definitely the hardest to do in a straight line and fixed. And then I decide here to flip around and buzz myself, and this actually scared me because it sounded so loud as it went past me like that. It sounded like I was just gonna plow into my own head, but I didn't. That probably would have hurt. Okay, this is a second flight. I saw some ATVers come down the canyon. I'm like, all right, great, I got something, a subject to shoot, and something to chase and practice. So obviously I'm controlling the camera and the helicopter myself at the same time. Unfortunately, if it's not planned, when most people see the chopper up in the air, they stop and stare at it, which doesn't make for great shots. So I decided to fly up the canyon a little bit ways, get out of their sight, and then wait for them to start moving so I could practice tracking a vehicle or moving object. And they're not moving, so I just go past. The camera wasn't mounted very securely. There's part of it came loose, so I'm getting side to side movement vibration, which is just a practice light. So, all right, there they're moving. Not very fast. So I'm just making this up as I go along, just seeing where they're at and trying to find an angle that captures the setting with, like, right here where they're in the foreground, and then you got the mountains and the lake in the background, although I didn't execute that movement quite as well as I'd like, but then I come back to home base and spot a truck. A white truck up there on the road, so decided to go check that out. And he's coming down the canyon, so figure I'll come turn back around, get set up for a buzz shot where I just buzz them, just fly right over the center of them. There's me sitting on the rock. Hit that straight on, but it's difficult because I'm actually was flying uphill there. It's hard to tell from the video. And then I realize that's the Forest Service. And I just buzz the Forest Service. I'm like, oh, great. So like, I better bring it in to landing before. When people start come up and talk to me, you never know what they're going to do, if they're going to knock over my antenna or whatever. And since I am looking at the video goggles, I can't really do much. So bring it in for a landing. And that's that. That's yesterday at about 9,500 feet elevation. Flew good, a little bit windy. Need to secure the camera a little bit better and we'll be good.